morning, my dear student. How are you today? I hope you're all fine. Today we will talk about Unit 2, Lesson 1. Unit 2, Lesson 1, Universal Force in Nature. Universal Force in Nature. First, I will ask you, if you put an object on the table like this, for example, if you put book or any object on the table like this, and leave it for a long period of time, then return back again to see it. What can you observe? We can observe that the book on the table, without changing in its place. Why the book remains on the table? Because there is no force acts on it. There is nobody move it. So it remains on its place. Today we will talk about the meaning of the force. What does it mean? Force, it is an effect that change the phase or the state of the object. The state of the object from static to motion or vice versa. Okay, so the force, what does it mean? It is an effect that it change the state of the object from rest to motion or vice versa. Vice versa, it means from motion to rest. And also change the direction. And also change what? Change the direction. Okay, is it clear? So, if I ask you, define the force. The force, it is an effect that it change an object phase. It means an object state from static to motion or from rest to motion and vice versa. It means from motion to rest, okay? And also change the motion direction. The force can be classified into three types. Number one, attraction force. So, if I ask you, the force can be classified into three types, which are number one, attraction force, number two, electromagnetic force, number three, nuclear force. So, the force can be classified into three types, which are attraction force, electromagnetic force, and nuclear force. Okay, and now let's talk about the attraction force. Let's talk about the first point, attraction force. Before, we said the earth can attract all objects. The earth can attract all objects due to the gravitational force or due to the effect of weight. And now we will talk about the attraction force. The earth's gravity force to the object. Earth can attract all objects. So the earth can attract all objects to its center. To what? To its center by force called or known as object's weight. So the earth can attract all objects to its center by its weight or by the weight. So object's weight is what is the ability of the earth to attract that object to its center. So here I'm talking about the attraction force of the earth or the gravity force to object. As we said before, the earth can attract objects to its center by the effect of weight. And the weight, it means the ability of the earth to attract that object to its center. So if I ask you, write the scientific term, the ability of the earth to attract objects to its center, it will be what? It will be the weight. So the earth can attract all objects to its center by the effect of weight. And what the meaning of weight? Weight is the ability of the earth to attract objects to its center. So if you want to calculate the weight of an object by using this law. Number one, the weight equal the mass or the object's mass, simplified with the letter M, and time the earth's gravity. Okay, the earth's gravity or the gravity or the gravity acceleration. The gravity acceleration, the word acceleration, a new word, gravity acceleration, it means the gravitational force, okay? So the gravity acceleration equal what? 9.8, nearly equal 10, and it's unit meter per second square. So the Earth, again, the Earth can attract all objects to its center, number one. Number two, weight is the ability of the Earth to attract objects to its center. And we can calculate the weight from this relation. Weight equal mass time acceleration, and the acceleration equal what? 9.8 or nearly equal 10. Okay, is it clear? Okay, so let's talk about the second point. So the force of attraction increases when the object's masses increases. When what? When the masses increases or become larger. So there is a direct relationship. There is a direct relationship between the gravitational force or between the attraction force and the mass. It means what? It means by increasing the mass of the object, what will happen? By increasing the mass of the object, the gravitational force to the Earth will increase, and by decreasing the mass of the object, the gravitational force will decrease. So there is a direct relationship between the attraction force and what? And the mass. By increasing the mass of the object, the attraction force, what will happen? The attraction force will increase. So an object weight changes from place to another. An object's weight changes from place to another on the Earth's surface. Okay, it means what? It means the weight is changeable. The weight of object is changed from one place to another. So the weight is changeable value, but the mass is constant. The mass of an object on Earth equal to its mass on moon. So mass is constant. Mass is constant. Mass is constant. Weight is changeable. Okay, is it clear? Okay, let's talk about the second point in our lesson. Electromagnetic force. Electromagnetic force. Electromagnetic force. So we finished the first point, which is called attraction force and the gravity and the weight. Okay, let's talk about the electromagnetic force. Electromagnetic force, it means magnetic force produced from what? Produced by the effect of passing what? Passing of electric current through a coil. Okay, so if we have any, for example, if we have we will do this activity. If we have a plastic tube, it's opened from its sides, okay? And we coil a copper wire around it and connect the copper wire with the battery and insert a bar of iron inside this bottle that opened from its sides and put iron powder or iron fillings near to the iron bar. What can you observe? We can observe that the iron bar attracts all the iron fillings. The iron bar inside that found inside the plastic bottle, عمل ايه بقى? Attract all iron powder. Why? Because this iron bar works as a magnet. Because the iron bar works as a magnet, and this force that attracts the iron powder or iron fillings called magnetism or magnetic force. So the magnetic force produced by the effect of passing electric current through a coil. Okay, what are the applications on electromagnetic force? What are the applications on electromagnetic force? Electromagnetic force, we can use it in making electromagnet. The electromagnet, before we talked about it, made of so the electromagnet is made of isolated copper wire. So made of what, ya ولاد? copper wire around a bar of soft iron. So the electromagnet, we can make it by using iron nail and coil copper wire around it. So the iron will be a magnet. The iron will be a magnet. When an electric current passes through it, it works as a magnet. It works as a magnet. So again, here I'm talking about what? I'm talking about the electromagnetic force. I'm talking about electromagnetic force. Electromagnetic force, it is magnetic force or magnetism produced by the effect of what? Of passing electric current through a coil. Of passing what? Of passing electric current through a coil. So what are the applications on electromagnetic force? Number one, electromagnet. Number one, electromagnet. So electromagnet is made of copper wire. Number one, copper wire. Number two, soft iron or soft iron nail. So if I ask you, the electromagnet is made of number one, copper wire. Number two, soft iron. So when the electric current passes through it, it works as a magnet. It works as a magnet. So this is the main idea of working the electromagnet by passing electric current. It works as what? It works as a magnet. Okay, is it clear? Okay, let's talk about the uses of electromagnet. The uses of electromagnet. What are the uses of electromagnet? We can use electromagnet, number one, in making electric bells. Do you know the electric bell? Yes, all of us know the electric bell. So the uses of electromagnet, number one, in making electric bell. Number two, in making electric wrenches. Electric wrenches or electric cranes. Okay, so the wrench or crane is used to lift a heavy object. If you want to raise or lift a heavy object, you can use a wrench or electric wrench or crane to lift it. Okay, number two, electric generator. Number two, electric generator. So number one, number one, we talked about the electromagnet and the uses of electromagnet. As we said, the electromagnet is used in making electric bells and in the electric wrenches or cranes. And now let's talk about the second point, electric generator. Electric generator. Okay, electric generator or the dynamo. So in electromagnet, an electromagnet from its name, electromagnet. So the electric energy changes into magnetic energy from the idea of working the electromagnet. So if I ask you, a device changes electric energy into magnetic energy, it will be electromagnet. It will be what? Electromagnet. So electromagnet, it changes what? It changes electric energy.